After a rough start to the first half yesterday, Deion Jackson and top-ranked Providence-St. Mel looked very much like the number one team in the state. They try to prove it here today in the state championship game, taking on the Twin Towers, not the ones down the street here in downtown Peoria, but Christian and his brother, Julian Stadley, a double-double, averaging a double-double his last two games heading into the state championship game. It's the capital city of America's original March Madness, year 23 in Peoria, and we've got two of the top five teams in the state. One of them will take home a state championship here today. Good afternoon and welcome to Carver Arena in downtown Peoria. I'm Lee Hall along with Cameron Smith. Piper Shaw is with us as well. We've got top-ranked Providence-St. Mel looking to add to their great tradition, a tradition it's been a little while getting back here to the state championship game. It's been a while, right?
Yeah, these kids understand that tradition and they understand the history when it comes to basketball in Providence-St. Mel. And they want to return their program back to the throne of small school basketball, and they have a great opportunity today. Now, we saw how quickly yesterday they can change a game. Defensively, they're very quick. They get out in transition. They score a bunch of buckets, especially above the rim. Tim Irvin's group has their eyes set on that 1A state championship trophy.
On the other side for Cissna Park, they've had a great run. The Stadley twins have been impressive. Christian leading the way, as we mentioned, averaging a double-double, very near a double-double yesterday as they play for a state title the first time in school history today.
Lee, they've been preaching all season long to go from good to great, and achieving a state title would achieve that goal for them, from being good to great. And they were dominant inside the paint, and especially from three. But can that translate against the Knights of Providence-St. Mel? We'll find out shortly.
One of these teams will take home a state championship. It would be the first for Cissna Park, the first for Providence-St. Mel since way back in 1985. We've got the starting lineups and the pregame intros coming up.
The 2019 IHSA Basketball State Finals are brought to you by Country Financial. At Country Financial, we know preparing for your financial future can feel overwhelming. We want to help you take it one simple step at a time at takesimplesteps.com. And by Busey, your dream, our promise.
I was in a terrible accident when I was 14 years old. My recovery was a challenge, to say the least. What I have learned from this experience has inspired me to help others overcome their obstacles. My name is Stephen Carroll, and I'm a Country Financial representative. I do what I do now to help people achieve their goal, one step at a time.
Find a representative at takesimplesteps.com.
All across America, teenagers are making a difference, gaining respect, and changing the future. Here in Illinois, the future is now. 16 and 17-year-olds can now register to be organ tissue donors in Illinois. Nearly 5,000 people in our state need a life-saving organ, and about 300 people die every year waiting. Be part of the solution. Join the Illinois Secretary of State's Organ Tissue Donor Registry. Register at lifegoeson.com.
This event is brought to you by Champion. Since 1919, Champion has created the durable, authentic sportswear you need to conquer your goals. As the official uniform and apparel provider for the NFHS, Champion helps athletes at every level make their mark, the mark of a champion. View our apparel today at champion.com.
For a moment of silence, as we remember the men and women of the armed forces serving us here and around the world away from their families, protecting our freedom.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Austin Garriott, a senior at Lincoln High School. Let's meet the starting lineups for the Class 1A 2019 championship game for the Timberwolves of Cissna Park. A forward, a 6'7 senior, 35, Julian Stadley. At center, a 6'7 senior, 40, Christian Stadley. The guards for the Timberwolves, a 5'10 senior, 5, Connor Lober. Another guard, a 5'9 senior, 14, Bailey Sluice. And the third guard, a 6'2 senior, 22, Brian Fair. 24 years at Cissna Park, a record of 459 and 270, head coach Kevin Long. Now let's meet the Knights of Providence-St. Mel. At center, a 6'9 senior, 33, Tayon Neal. At a guard, a 5'6 senior, 2, Tim Irvin II. Another guard for the Knights, a 6'5 senior, 10, Jason Mason. Another guard, a 6'3 senior, 13, Deion Jackson. And the fourth guard for St. Mel, a 6'1 senior, 15, Tyrell Nelson. Head coach for St. Mel for 13 years, a record of 220 and 155, Tim Irvin.
Well, how about that intro? I'm fired up. I know you're fired up.
You know it.
Kudos to Russ Leonard and our crew for putting together that pregame video. That was outstanding work, ladies and gentlemen. Fantastic stuff. We are just about ready to go. Piper Shaw is along with us. Let's go to her. Piper.
Guys, when I asked the guys over at Cissna Park about to describe their team, without hesitation, they told me they are a brotherhood. They've been playing together since they were kids. They even won a state championship together in seventh grade with Coach Long by their side that whole time. And to make it here today, if they win this, they will be the smallest 1A school to win this state title. Coach Long says there's only 87 kids at Cissna Park. And on top of that, he says his favorite thing about this team is their ability to overcome adversity. And after coaching for 24 years, when the final buzzer goes today, Coach Long will step off the court with his seniors for the last time as he retires. Guys, a special game for Cissna Park here today.
Absolutely, and the players talking about how special it is for them to play in the last game coached by Kevin Long. Made it here one other time back in 03 where they lost in the quarterfinals. And what better way, he says, to go out with a better group like this. He said yesterday after the win, I'm proud beyond words.
Yeah, he's put in so many hours with not just these kids, but so many teams that have come through Cissna Park, and they love him. He's a family member to them. He's not just a high school coach. And for them to be able to try and have him finish his career on top, it would be a great achievement. But on the flip side, Providence-St. Mello saying, hey, we want to send our coach out with the final season for him this year with the state championship. I'm excited for this one. This is going to be a great game.
Jim Irvin coaching his last game with his son, TJ Irvin, in the lineup. So good storylines on both sides here today as we tip off our 1A state championship game. Number one, Providence-St. Mel. Number five, Cissna Park. They look for the alley-oop to Christian Stadley, and it goes out of bounds.
Even though that play didn't work out for Cissna Park, I like that idea. You try and throw a lob to try and get a dunk to set a statement to Providence-St. Mel that, hey, you guys aren't the only ones that have athletic bigs.
Fair gives it to Stadley. Christian Stadley averages 17 points, almost 8 rebounds a game.
Yeah, he had a huge game yesterday. Was so dominant for Cissna Park. 17 points, 9 rebounds, 2 blocks for the first team All-Stater.
They look for a little lob inside. It's broken up and lost out of bounds. We get a look at Tim Irvin, his 13th season at Providence-St. Mel. We mentioned yesterday, you know, we talked in the first game about Coach Lewis from Triopia and how his career was kind of 32 years or so in between head coaching gigs. Tim Irvin coached for 3 seasons, was fired by his alma mater, St. Mel, in 03. Came back, and since 09, he's got 3 20-win seasons, and this is his second trip to state. They were third in 2014, playing for a state title here today.
Well, how many people go back to the place that they were fired? It just speaks to the love that Tim Irvin has for Providence-St. Mel and also the west side of Chicago. They pass out from Stadley out of the post. That's going to be a matchup you're going to be watching the entire afternoon. Tayon Neal, Christian Stadley.
And just in case you're wondering, the Stadley twins combined are 2 for 6 on the entire year from three-point range. They worked on it a little in the summer, but their game is down low for sure.
Yes, it is. And a lot of hours into the gym just working on a lot of post moves, and you see it there paying off. Even though they didn't get the 2, they draw a foul on the Knights.
And how about the angle on that entry pass inside to Stadler?
That's a lost art, feeding the post. A lot of kids don't know how to feed the basketball to a big into the post. So many different angles that you can utilize, ball fakes, bounce passes, also using that pivot to improve your angle. Solid job from the Wolves of feeding their bigs early in this ball game.
Tayon Neal playing really good defense down low, but able to get that angle. Stadley able to get that angle and then to get that pass inside to him. You see what he did in yesterday's ball game. Just a 56% free thrower on the year, so that's an Achilles heel for him and this entire Cissna Park team, but he knocks in both of those.
Yeah, he made that look easy.
We talked about St. Mel unable to get the game at their flow in yesterday's first half. Deion Jackson hits his first shot. We'll see how that works out here in the first half of this ball game.
And we really didn't see Deion Jackson come alive until the second half. That's a great sign for Tim Urban's group. If Jackson can get himself going and this young man can get himself going, the Knights will be in great position to get this ball game.
And that's just how quick it can happen. Stadley had the ball in the high post, just glanced away for a second, and Nelson was right there to take it away.
Listen, if you take a breath and relax, the Knights are going to take the ball away, just like we're seeing from Tyriel Nelson there. Hands, doesn't foul, but also gets a foul on Stadley. Two big plays from the senior.
79% at the line this year for the 6'2", 140-pound senior. All-stater, four-year starter for Tim Urban.
There's not too many guys that can stay in front of Tyriel Nelson. Huge reason why he's a first-team All-stater.
Splits the free throws.
Ball pressure from TJ Urban. He's going to be in the shorts of Connor Lober this entire afternoon. He does not let up when it comes to ball pressure. It just wears on you. It may not get you early, but over time, late third quarter, fourth quarter, you start to do uncharacteristic things with the ball. And that's TJ Urban's job.
A lot of movement here early for the T-Wolves.
Yes, and trying to space out the Knights, and that's a one way to break pressure, but you can't leave him wide open.
Bailey Sluice missing after hitting 4 3-pointers in yesterday's semifinal. The foul on the floor will go against Connor Lober, the 5'10", 165-pound senior guard.
Well, Lee, we saw a little bit of the transition from Central A&M in our third place game. Once they get that rebound, they throw it right out. The Knights do the same thing. Once they get the rebound, you're going to see two or three black jerseys just streak down the court, and that pass is coming.
Deion Neal, the miss, goes after it. Hustles after it. Nice job by the big fella. Nelson with a little teardrop.
Big time play from Deion Neal. The bucket from Nelson doesn't happen if Neal doesn't give up on the play. He continued with it. That's a lot of weight to move in a 6'9 frame, 260 pounds. He says, hey, Cam, we got to get this possession. We got to try and get some second chance points.
Take a look. I thought yesterday, as big as Deion Neal is, he was kind of light on his feet, and good hustle here as he sets up the basket for his teammate Tyriel Nelson, and an early lead for the number one ranked Knights of St. Mel.
You can spend it on anything.
Animals and toys. I would buy a really, really, really big house.
A motorcycle.
I would go to college right now.
Money.
Coats or watches. Anything.
When I was looking at different universities, I didn't want to choose a campus just for football. I needed a school that offered strong academics. At UNI, I discovered a program that gave me hands-on experience and connected me with industry professionals. I gained a better understanding of what it takes to be successful in a competitive industry. UNI helped me discover my passion of meeting people and telling important community-driven stories. Discover where you belong at the University of Northern Iowa.
If you're looking for a hotel while in Peoria, look no further than the Staybridge Suites in downtown. Location couldn't be any better. Staybridge right across the street from the Peoria Civic Center. The clean, comfortable rooms, indoor pool, and breakfast buffet make it the perfect spot for families. The in-room kitchen and on-site laundry make it perfect for the business traveler. Visit IHG.com for more information. When I say IH, it just automatically comes out IHSA.org. That's just,
I'm right there.
I remember first time I had to read that on the air. I was like, what is a .org? But there we get a look at Jason Mason. Favorite show, The Office. God bless you. Bears beats Battlestar Galactica. Favorite team, Golden State Warriors. And his other sport, golf.
Nice.
Oh, Neal with a block, whistled for the foul.
Yeah, Deion Neal has some of the best reactions when he doesn't feel the foul is on him. We need to create some GIFs or something, some memes of Deion Neal just reacting to those questionable foul calls in his mind. But here's the thing.
Little body there.
Yeah, a little body, and that's why they blew the whistle. But here's the thing with Neal. first few possessions for Cissna Park, when that ball went into the post, he just put his hand straight up, didn't try and go for the block. He's starting to feel good about himself. Hey, I got a couple of stops. They didn't score on me. Now let me try and go for a block. Well, Tim Irvin has to let him know, don't do that because we need you on the floor. They have to provide some resistance to at least one of the Stanley twins in that lane. If he goes to the bench, St. Mel is going to be in trouble.
Good job by Julian Stadley and Brian Fair to tap the misses out. And another possession for the Timberwolves. That's Connor Lober, just 4.5 points a game, putting it off the glass and good.
Well, Connor with the giant killer, tough shot off the glass on that angle. Very smart move just to let up a little bit and show that release.
Little in-between jumper for Jason Mason, who averages 10 a game.
He is so smooth. I love Jason Mason's game. So underrated in what he does and what he provides for Tim Irvin's group. Now, they know what he provides, but outside looking in, you don't understand how important he is to their attack.
He did not start earlier in the year. Tim Irvin says he's come on really strong of late.
Strong and athletic.
Comes to help, and it was Nelson getting a hand on that, swatting it away.
Yeah, beautiful timing from Tyriel.
And now the steal by Brian Fair.
Well, the big thing with these two teams coming into the game is pace. We talked about Providence-St. Mel, how quick they are, and they're going to get a trap there. Good job of Sluice getting out of it.
Julian Stadley, tough against the double team, tough shot. Here come the Knights the other way.
Oh, nice.
Deion Jackson to the hoop.
Deion Jackson. In and out. Into the lane. Floater. Come on, young man. Don't do that.
Brings back some good memories calling Bradley games back here. There was a Deion Jackson that played for Bradley when they won the Missouri Valley Conference crown in 96. So I have a lot of practice saying, Deion Jackson. With some enthusiasm.
That's just a great sports name. Not
it
even
is.
Just basketball, man. It's
Deion
a great sports
Jackson,
name.
Jason Mason. I still like that one the best.
And one of my favorites, Carmelo. Carmelo Anthony.
Stadley, double team. Gives it back out to Lober. Now gets it back. Over the double team. Neal got a hand on it. Swats it ahead to Jackson.
Whoa.
And now Fair whistled for the intentional foul.
Wow.
Got both arms around him, and he's whistled for the intentional foul.
See, Deion Jackson is trying to compose himself, and T.J. Irvin is going to put his arms around his teammate, say, hey, just relax. We got the intentional foul. Very fortunate that no one was hurt on this play, especially for Jackson.
Well, I thought he had both arms around him.
Yeah, from the different angle, it looks.
Yeah, it doesn't look as bad. Yeah. From our angle, it looked kind of bad. That angle, officials are out there for a reason, though. They're on top of their game for getting a state championship call here today.
I'll say this, Lee. The worst thing that you can do is upset a really good player. You do that, then things change.
So he splits the free throws. It'll be Providence-St. Mel ball.
Look at that in and out. I mean, right past Fair and the giant killer over Julian Stafford. Deion Jackson has so much in his bag. I'm sure he's going to put it on display, but you just get a small taste of it. Doesn't stretch his game out to the perimeter much. But everything 15-foot beating in, he's good, just like Tyriel Nelson is.
Puts it on the floor and scores. Tim Irvin says he can score at all three levels. Inside, outside, put it on the floor. It's a six-point lead now for St. Mel.
Timberwolves have to understand that Tayon Neal is out of the game. Try and get something inside of that paint. That big presence is absent. Either attack it with the ball penetration, dribble penetration, or feed the post with the Stadley twins.
Christian trying to post up Jason Mason. Mason doing a good job of staying active, getting around and covering the angles.
Yeah. And it's a great job from the help side as well.
Julian Stadley wanted it inside, and a foul away from the ball will go against St. Mel's. Avante Thomas playing defense down low.
Neal's going to come right back into this ball game for
Avante Thomas. Just giving Neil a quick spell. Let him catch his breath. Get him back onto the court. So that conversation was had between Coach Irvin and Tayon Neal that he's going to play a lot of minutes this afternoon. They need him in the ball game.
Julian blocked by Neal, gets it back. A couple of blocks so far by Neal, and here's the takeaway by Nelson. Tyrell Nelson. The steal, the bucket, and now the timeout for Kevin Long in Cissna Park.
Well, this is what so many teams in the city of Chicago have seen when they face the Knights of Providence-St. Mel. They force you to play their game and into uncharacteristic turnovers. You take a breath, and you're going to look up at the scoreboard, and you'll be down big. Neal with the big block there, and here comes Nelson. Eliminates the defender with that crossover to get back to the right side. And when he's that close to the basket, he knows what to do with it. See, that crossover eliminates his defender. He's going to get right up to the rim for another bucket.
A 9-0 run for the Knights.
Nelson already has 7 points. We're kind of getting towards the end of the first quarter. Just how explosive these Knights are.
Three steals already.
Yeah. Doing it in the Jordans too, patent leather Jordans, the iconic ones. You got those in your sneaker closet, right, Lee?
He's got sneaker grip. See how well I learned there.
That was perfect.
Julian to Christian, the Stadley twins can share. 6 points for Christian.
Very nice breaking of the pressure from the Timberwolves. Not overusing the dribble, using the pass. Great work.
I'll just point out, I know I'm old, but I am coachable.
All right. So we've been working on this drip thing with Lee all weekend. So if you know what drip is, then you're good. But if you don't know what drip is, it means you've got a nice fashion sense. You've got some style, too.
I know that. Here's Sluice from outside.
That's a big foul. That's number two on Neal.
And a whistle on Neal as the ball rattled around and went out of bounds. And that is two on the big fella. Honorable mention All-Stater. Foul trouble has been his bugaboo. And he'll have to come out, and Avante Thomas will come back in. We'll get our first look at number 24, Ian Rogers, the sophomore for Cissna Park. And the Greater Peoria Airport has been made aware because he will let it fly. Here's Fair taking it to the hoop. Unable to finish. He had a good look.
Yeah, I think Fair didn't realize how wide open he was. Just kind of rushed that layup. Tim Irvin saying one shot. They're going to let Tyrell Nelson just try and break down his defender.
The give to Thomas for the layup. It's an 11-2 run for Providence-St. Mel, number one in the state. And they, I would say, are playing their tempo and lead it here by 8 after 8 minutes.
Oh, nice.
The summer, Coach Ellis coming up to me and saying, we might have a family moving here from France.
My name is Louis.
My name is Roland.
And I just moved here in Evanston 3 months ago.
Basketball has a way of holding you accountable.
That's what's great about sports, is it's about habits. You know, you're building habits.
Always.
The NFHS Learning Center is the leader in online education for the interscholastic community.
At NFHSLearn.com, you can find over 60 courses for coaches, administrators, officials, parents, students, and performing arts programs, including over 25 free courses such as concussion in sports, heat illness prevention, sudden cardiac arrest, and protecting students from abuse. For more information, visit the NFHS Learning Center.
Are on sale for America's Original March Madness in Peoria. Great seats still available at the Peoria Civic Center box office or on Ticketmaster. Every game ticket also includes entry into the March Madness Experience Fan Fest. Call 309-663-6377 or visit Ticketmaster.com for more information. Let's go inside the Cissna Park huddle.
You guys gotta use your toolbox right now. Okay? You're too predictable. It's just face up and one move. Use your counter moves. Go to your counter moves, right? Take all the tools out of the shed and use them. Let's get a clean rebound here. The ball coming out. Let's have some pace. All right, we need to buckle up on the defensive end. A lot of mid-range shots.
Words of wisdom from Kevin Long. I like that. And adjustments, that's key in any ball game, in any sport, adjustments. Go to the tool shed, yeah. Bring out all the tools.
You got to bring out everything that you learned as a kid, I mean, up until this point, because that first move is going to get stopped. What's that second? What's that third counter move, as Coach Long said? St. Mel is too quick. They're too athletic to do just a one dribble move and go up to the rim.
And they've got to play better defense. St. Mel shooting 78% from the floor in the first half, 7-9.
And 10 of their points, 10 of their 16 points, I should say, have come in the paint. They've lived in the paint.
Little alley-oop to Jason Mason. The look from Eric Jordan.
There has to be communication on that help side. If you know that Mason's on the wing and you're getting back screen, that help defender has to at least put a body on Mason just to slow him down a little bit so he can recover. It's the second time the Knights have tried to run that, or have run that alley-oop play.
St. Mel up 10 as Julian Stadley takes it inside, unable to finish, and here comes St. Mel the other way. TJ Irvin, high off the glass, no good.
Great pass out from Harrington.
And Irvin whistled for the travel.
See this back screen here. You see Irvin with the back screen on Stanley, but that can't happen. If you're Keegan Boyle, you have to be able to kind of give Mason a nice little nudge just to slow him down so you can have Stanley come back into the play.
Cissna Park so hot from the three-point range in the early going yesterday, 0-for-2 behind the arc.
They shot 62% from three in the opening quarter.
St. Mel's covering them well beyond the three-point line.
Yes, they are. They know where those shooters are. You see Eric Jordan right there on the hip of Bailey Sloops. He's not letting them breathe.
Irvin the takeaway.
Look how quickly the Knights get up the court. That's just pressure alone when you have to exert so much energy just to get back to stop them. Now when you stop them, you got to stop them again in the half court.
Harrington fouled. Brian Fair picks up his second on the reach. Rogers back in for Cissna Park. He'll replace Fair. He'll take a seat with those two fouls.
Ian Rogers has the green light to put up a shot basically anywhere on the court once they cross that court. It's a knockdown shooter. Ian Bailey Sluice of the featured guys when Cissna Park needs a three.
Well, the way St. Mel's playing defense, he may have to shoot it at half court.
Yeah,
Irvin knocks down the three.
Wow, speaking of shooting from half court, that was kind of getting back towards half court from that three from TJ Irvin.
And St. Mel has picked up where they left off yesterday in the second half against Triopia. They trailed by one at halftime yesterday. And then blitzed the Trojans in the second half.
A lot of time left in this first half. So you're down at this point. If you're Cissna Park, you have to chip away at the lead. I like the aggression from Stadley. Just didn't get it to finish.
Didn't use the glass, didn't finish. Neal on the bench with a couple of fouls for St. Mel, leaving them an opportunity to attack inside. Harrington into the lane, blocked by Julian Stadley. And St. Mel gets it back.
So patient on the offensive end. And Tim Irvin is almost like he's on the court coaching, but he's almost playing because he's just directing his team to slow down and get them in their sets.
Devontae Thomas, the offensive rebound to keep it at the St. Mel end.
He's just trying to spread the floor. Coach Irvin's directing Harrington to get to the basket.
Christian Stadley the rebound. Julian down low, left-hander, no good.
Great post position from Julian. He just has to finish it. We've seen time and time again from the Stadley twins that they have great position. They're just not completing the play with a layup.
And both of those players shoot over 70%. In fact, Christian shooting 77% on the season.
It's amazing.
Breaking his record, he shot 72% a year ago. Jordan from the corner knocks down the three. He's a natural scorer, according to his coach.
That was shades of Klay Thompson right there from Jordan. Relocated to the corner. Irvin found him. Quick release. That was pretty.
10-0 run. And St. Mel can add to it here. Look at TJ Irvin. Wow. Once he gets ahead of steam, man. No catching him.
You need a neck brace. How quickly the Knights just get out of transition. So quickly. Don't stop the basketball. They're just going to keep going.
It'll be free throws for the Knights when we come back. They lead it by 16.
All across America, teenagers are making a difference, gaining respect, and changing the future. Here in Illinois, the future is now. 16 and 17-year-olds can now register to be organ tissue donors in Illinois. Nearly 5,000 people in our state need a life-saving organ, and about 300 people die every year waiting. Be part of the solution. Join the Illinois Secretary of State's Organ Tissue Donor Registry. Register at lifegoeson.com.
We started growing pumpkins and selling pumpkins in a roadside stand the first year my 10-year-old was born. People come, pick out their pumpkins, and they put their money in the box. We have the kids help out on the farm, and they get to keep the money for their college savings.
With my kids and my customers, my goal is to improve their situation.
With Country Financial, if you just take simple steps, preparing for college isn't as overwhelming as you think. Find an authorized representative near you at takesimplesteps.com.
Tonight at 7:15 on NBC Sports Chicago Plus, it's the IHSA Boys Basketball Class 2A Championship. Watch as Chicago Orr takes on Nashville for the state title. You can also live stream the game at NBCSportsChicago.com/IHSA. And that's something we want to talk about a little bit, Cam, is Chicago could sweep the state tournaments.
Yes.
We'll get more back on that in just a minute. First, we got to get the Bailey Sluice. Talent you wish you had. Preach. Dunk. Yes, me too. Any phobias, blood, strangest food you've eaten? Crickets.
Okay, that's a good strangest food.
That's different. That's better than cheeseburger.
Yeah,
we had that yesterday.
Yeah. Cheeseburger is not fun.
Crickets, no. And I hope he won some money on that bet or something.
Yeah, he has to. But then that's a knock to the Stadley twins. You wish you could dunk. Come on, Julian, Christian, just lift them up. You know, let them get a running start, and you guys are strong enough. You bench over 400 pounds. You squat over 400 pounds. Lift Bailey up and let him get some air.
DJ Irvin, 74% free throw around the year, and this is an important stretch for Cissna Park if they are to stay in this game.
100% correct on that lead. We saw them have success against this 1-2-2, and they switch it, but 10-second violation right there for the Timberwolves. Just a little too relaxed.
Irvin brings it across for St. Mel, up 25-8 here. It's been a long scoring drought for Cissna Park.
St. Mel's going to stay five wide. Coach Irvin is instructing his guys to spread the floor, get some spacing. That's a bad shot from Deion Jackson. As good as he is, he forced that one. But the Timberwolves is a stop. So now you get the ball back offensively, Cissna Park. Get that ball across. And I was going to get to the point of that they've had success against this 1-2-2 zone. They just have to move the basketball.
6 minutes and counting since Cissna Park scored. Sluice for three. Rebound for Christian Stanley. He'll kick it back out.
Stanley got away with the double dribble there.
Feeling the system needs a three to go in. Sluice will try again and gets it.
Bailey Sluice says, Lee, I hear you. That is a huge three, especially a big confidence booster for the Timberwolves. Got to St. Mel lead to 14.
First basket since 57 seconds to go in the first quarter.
That is a heck of a pass from Kelsey to Deion Jackson.
Deion Jackson now with seven. Christian Stanley takes advantage of the mismatch. How did T.J. Irvin end up on him?
I mean, Irvin is giving up about 10 inches there. That ball, smart move from the Timberwolves to get it right into Stanley for the two.
Good recognition.
Yes. See the defense picking up, especially Ian Rodgers defending Tyrell Nelson.
Quick jump ball call there, and it will go to Cissna Park. Jason Mason back into the ball game for St. Mel.
See Tyrell Nelson just doing a little too much deep into the lane, but that's a credit to the Timberwolves and Ian Rodgers. The pressure calls that turnover. Another stop. If you can get a bucket, it's big. It adds to the confidence. As we keep closer to halftime, Kevin Long's group needs it.
Here's Sluice again for three. He hit four of them in yesterday's semifinal win. Jordan from the top of the key. Look at Jackson. Skied for the rebound. Doesn't get the foul to go. Gives it to Mason. Blocked by Christian Stanley. And the whistle on Christian Stanley. That will be his second personal foul.
You have to get a second look at that one because up top it looked clean. See this possession from the Knights, and credit to them creating those second chance opportunities. Jackson doesn't get that one to go. Here comes Jason Mason on the other end and didn't get a look at the block, but obviously a lot of Timberwolves fans were upset with that call. Jason Mason going old school. Can you call them goggles anymore?
I'm pretty sure
you can call them it's eyewear. Maybe nowadays, but back in the day it was goggles.
You go ahead and call them goggles because I understand the reference.
Yeah.
So and somewhere, Kurt Rambis would be proud. Not to mention Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Cap. I remember about fourth grade, my mom tried to give me goggles. I'm like, no, I'm not getting laughed out the gym. It's not going to happen.
See, we had the knee pad, sweatband.
See, we had everything.
The shorty shorts.
But you know what?
It was the 70s.
But it's going back to that, though. Kids are wearing the shorts shorter. They're wearing the knee pads and the sleeves and all of that. Even mouth guards, too.
Final seconds. First half. Number one, St. Mel in charge here, holding for the last shot.
Great defense from Cissna Park.
Jackson shot for three, doesn't go, but an impressive first half for St. Mel. They got off to a slow start yesterday. Not the case today. Shooting 55% in the first half and holding Cissna Park under 28% shooting. Let's go over to Piper Shaw.
Hey, guys, I've got Providence-St. Male's head coach Tim Urban here. Now, you guys have had a great first half. What's working for you?
We're playing solid defense, making it real tough for them to get shots off. I think they maybe made only one three in the first half. I know making threes is an important part of their offensive strategy. So that's what's been helpful for us, stopping them on making threes. And we've been scoring the basketball today. We've been finishing around the basket, so that's been good for us.
What adjustments might you be making in the second half?
Just in making sure that they don't, we don't let the three-pointers get going, and make sure we make it tough for the bigs in the post.
All right, thanks so much, Coach. Good luck. All right, Lee, over to you.
All right, Piper. Well, yesterday when he was asked about making adjustments at halftime, are you going to change anything? Nope. I don't think he'd change anything today either.
Greatest quote. I loved it.
St. Mel in control here at halftime.
When I was looking at different universities, I didn't want to choose a campus just for football. I needed a school that offered strong academics. At UNI, I discovered a program that gave me hands-on experience and connected me with industry professionals. I gained a better understanding of what it takes to be successful in a competitive industry. UNI helped me discover my passion of meeting people and telling important community-driven stories. Discover where you belong at the University of Northern Iowa.
You can spend it on anything.
Animals and toys. I would buy a really, really, really big house.
A motorcycle.
I would go to college right now.
Money.
Coats or watches. Anything.
St. Mel over Cissna Park 29-13 at halftime in our 1A state title game. Welcome into Carver Arena. I'm Piper Shaw. We've got a fast game here in the first half. Cameron Smith, our broadcast analyst, joins us to talk about what we have seen. Now, just the sheer energy of Providence-St. Mel is hard to beat. How does Cissna even defend against that?
Well, the first thing they have to do is just take a breath. Relax. I know the energy is there from Providence-St. Mel, and you just see all the black jerseys flying all over the place. If they give some ball fakes, just stay composed and make sure that they're meeting their passes. That's one way to break the pressure. Another way is to try and feed the Stadley twins inside, especially when Tayon Neal is out of the game. He picked up a couple of fouls, set for the majority of the first half, and when that happened, you didn't see a lot of post entries or baskets inside the lane from the Timberwolves. But again, it's the second half. You have a lot of ball game to be played. They're down 16. It's not an insurmountable lead, so they have to be able to chip away at the lead that the Knights have. It's going to be a tough job, but they are capable of doing it because they have shooters in Bailey Sluice, who knocked down a three in the second quarter, as we saw, and also Ian Rogers.
Now, Cissna Park is just getting lost in those transitions. How can they clean it up?
Simple and plain. If you're not going in for a rebound, get back. That's it. If you're not one of the Stadley twins, get back. We don't need a Bailey Sluice or a Connor Lober or Ian Rogers, any one of those guys getting stuck in the paint, because what's happening is when the Knights get that rebound, you see one black jersey on the white right wing, you see another on the left wing, and they're just launching that ball to create their transition. And when they catch the ball, they're already at half court. Two or three more dribbles, they're at the rim. So the message that Kevin Long has to give his players is, look, if you're not in the area, just get back, because we have to make sure that we're defending our rim. And that's one of the main reasons why St. Mel has this 16-point lead.
Mm-hmm. Now, the Stadley twins aren't necessarily playing their best game either. How can they get on the court and help their team out here?
Well, they have to get the post entries. They have to be able to get that basketball and finish. Like, we've seen them in the first half get some great positions right at the rim, but they just don't convert those layups. So we've known that they put in the hours with Coach Long over the summer, throughout the season, that they were working on jump hooks and understanding how to finish, especially against defenders that may be like size or a little bit smaller. So when they get that timing, relax, go up, finish the play, get back on defense.
And Providence-St. Mel is really just dominating. What do you see that is working for them?
Well, the question is, what isn't working for St. Mel? They are doing a great job defending, but also, more importantly, staying composed within how they run their offense. Yes, they're going to run in transition. They're going to score in transition. That's just what they do. But what they're getting in the half court is just isolation situations where you have a Tyrell Nelson who has 7 points, or a Deion Jackson who also has 7 points, break down their defenders one-on-one and either get in the lane and you see a dump off to a big that's diving towards the rim, or they got the short pull-up jumper or the floater to get over the Stanley Twins. So they're just clicking on all cylinders. Even the guys off the bench have given Tim Urban's group some great minutes on the court.
Cameron, thank you so much. We'll see if Cissna Park can pull it off here in the second half. But look who is back here at the Peoria Civic Center. We've got Rocket Man. He's from Oakville. He's from Oakville. We'll be back with more second half action right after this.
I was in a terrible accident when I was 14 years old. My recovery was a challenge, to say the least. What I have learned from this experience has inspired me to help others overcome their obstacles. My name is Stephen Carroll, and I'm a country financial representative. I do what I do now to help people achieve their goal, one step at a time.
Find a representative at TakeSimpleSteps.com.
All across America, teenagers are making a difference, gaining respect, and changing the future. Here in Illinois, the future is now. 16 and 17-year-olds can now register to be organ tissue donors in Illinois. Nearly 5,000 people in our state need a life-saving organ, and about 300 people die every year waiting. Be part of the solution. Join the Illinois Secretary of State's Organ Tissue Donor Registry. Register at lifegoeson.com.
This event is brought to you by Champion. Since 1919, Champion has created the durable, authentic sportswear you need to conquer your goals. As the official uniform and apparel provider for the NFHS, Champion helps athletes at every level make their mark, the mark of a champion. View our apparel today at champion.com.
Here at Carver Arena in our 1A state title game, Providence-St. Mel over Cissna Park 29-13. We'll be back after this break with more second half action. Stay with us.
The NFHS Learning Center is the leader in online education for the interscholastic community. At nfhslearn.com, you can find over 60 courses for coaches, administrators, officials, parents, students, and performing arts programs, including over 25 free courses such as concussion in sports, heat illness prevention, sudden cardiac arrest, and protecting students from abuse. For more information, visit the NFHS Learning Center.
All across America, teenagers are making a difference, gaining respect, and changing the future. Here in Illinois, the future is now. 16 and 17-year-olds can now register to be organ tissue donors in Illinois. Nearly 5,000 people in our state need a life-saving organ, and about 300 people die every year waiting. Be part of the solution. Join the Illinois Secretary of State's Organ Tissue Donor Registry. Register at lifegoeson.com.
We started growing pumpkins and selling pumpkins in a roadside stand the first year my 10-year-old was born. People come, pick out their pumpkins, and they put their money in the box. We have the kids help out on the farm, and they get to keep the money for their college savings. With my kids and my customers, my goal is to improve their situation.
With Country Financial, if you just take simple steps, preparing for college isn't as overwhelming as you think. Find an authorized representative near you at TakeSimpleSteps.com.
Welcome back into Carver Arena. I have got Coach Kevin Long here with me from Cissna Park. Now, how do you take back the pace here in the second half and control this game for you guys?
We're on our heels. They punched us in the mouth the first half. We've got to be more aggressive. We've got to play more north and south. We're playing east and west right now. Way too tentative in our attack. We got too many weapons to have 13 points at the half. We're going to amp up the defense the second half, see if we can't get back in it.
Thank you so much, Coach. Good luck.
Thank you.
All right, we'll be back after the break with more second half action.
You can spend it on anything.
Animals and toys. I would buy a really, really, really big house.
A motorcycle.
I would go to college right now.
Money.
Put it in a shoe.
Coats. Or watches, anything.
When I was looking at different universities, I didn't want to choose a campus just for football. I needed a school that offered strong academics. At UNI, I discovered a program that gave me hands-on experience and connected me with industry professionals. I gained a better understanding of what it takes to be successful in a competitive industry. UNI helped me discover my passion of meeting people and telling important community-driven stories. Discover where you belong at the University of Northern Iowa.
Lee Hall, Cameron Smith back with you in Peoria. Piper Shaw is along with us. And boy, the stats tell the story of this game. The field goal percentage, the rebounds, the points in the paint. And if you look even deeper, Christian Stadley, 3 of 5 from the floor. Other than him, the rest of the Cissna Park team, 2 of 13 for 15% shooting.
Yeah, that just won't get it done. And we heard Coach Long tell Piper that they just came out and they punched us in the mouth. All right, they did that, but how do you respond? And I'm sure that was a message from Coach Long to his team at halftime. It's 16 minutes. A lot of ball game to be played. You're only down 16. It's a lot of time to get back within this lead, but it starts on the defensive end. It's a chance for Cissna Park to redeem themselves in the second half.
Yeah, coming into the weekend, they had allowed only 38 points per game, and St. Mel puts up 29 in the first half.
It's almost like you just blink, and St. Mel just took over and had it at their own pace and their own tempo.
There's a reason they're ranked number one, that's for sure.
Good job of walling out. That's a great defensive trip right there for Cissna Park.
Yep.
Close out the driving angle from Deion Jackson on the baseline with your body, not with trying to slap down with your hands, and force him into a tough pass. Some confusion on the sets that St. Mel is running to start this third quarter. They're just not in position.
Now that last pass was kind of a nobody, really. Neal kicks to Mason from the corner. Skying for the rebound is Tyrell Nelson. Doesn't get it to go. So a good opening defensive stand by Cissna Park. And they turn it into points at the other end.
Right there, just a little lackadaisical with that basketball. And the this offensive set. You want to see something again, going to the paint. Deion Neal has two fouls. Give it in to Christian Stadley. See if he can create a third.
Fair for three. 31 on the year.
Brian says, okay, Cam, I know you wanted to get this Stadley, but let me get this three off real quick. That was a smooth stroke.
Irvin driving dish to Neal for the easy bunny.
So quick. TJ Irvin open court. Neal's just waiting for that dish.
He's headed to UIC next season.
We saw former Fighting Illini great D. Brown here yesterday supporting Tayon Neal. He's an assistant for UIC. Steve McClain, head coach for the Flames, was here as well. Let's get a second look at Brian Fair.
Ooh,
that is deep.
That's deep.
That's NBA territory right there.
He was more of a scorer early in his career, but with the development of the Stadley twins, he hasn't had to do that as much. Oh, my! And that's an offensive foul on Neal, who leaned into Julian Stadley, who took a pretty good bump there.
I'm surprised that Julian Stadley's still breathing, man. That's it's a lot of mass coming right into your chest.
6'9", 260. And that's his third.
He stood in there and took it like a champ. I don't think Neal needed that little extra bump to go up. He had the move. That was just something extra. And it cost him. Solid job from Stadley on defending the post.
Glover down on the floor and calls timeout. Well, the teams have traded baskets here in the opening moments of the second half. Kevin Long winning his 500th career game in the super sectional, or the sectional final, semifinal, I should say. Again, this is the last game of his coaching career. Pretty casual with the toothpick.
Oh, man.
Channeling his inner Dusty Baker.
Coach is relaxing me.
I love meatloaf. I think he should tour again.
That kid needs a name. He needs a name. Not meatloaf, but he. What is his name? That's what we got to get. We got to get Piper Shaw on that.
Okay.
What is his name?
A nickname.
A nickname, right.
Yeah,
a nickname, right. We had Rocket Man. Saw
Rocket Man at halftime. I know.
I don't know what his nickname is going to be. Need something. Go, go.
I'm just going to say Hoss.
Yeah,
baby. Nice move by Julian Stadley for his first points of the game.
Yes, you see him. You see all five white jerseys just sprint back on the defensive end. That's what they need more of, whether it's a make or a miss. You have to sprint back in transition to be prepared for the Knights.
Neal from 15 feet. Keegan Boyle, the rebound. We saw him get fired up defensively yesterday, taking a couple of charges. Bad pass. Nelson right there to take it away. Take it all the way, and a call for the charge. Took it too far.
Credit Keegan Boyle standing right in there to take that charge. He's going to need a little breath really quickly. He's breathing a little hard because that was a hard impact, powerful impact.
He just mentioned the charges he took yesterday. Yeah. He is.
And wow. That's textbook. There was no flop. He didn't lean before the contact came. He took that right in his chest. That is a charge 100% of the way. And if you're Tyrell Nelson, you have TJ Irvin ahead. Give the ball up. Maybe you might get it back. You don't want to keep that ball in the hand. It just makes it easier for the defender.
Christian Stadley gets bumped off his feet there. Tayon Neal pick up his fourth foul. He wants a travel call. And that's his fourth.
Cissna Park fans know it as well. They stood right up and started cheering. These are the plays that Neal has to stay away from. Even if Stadley makes that spin, he has to regain his control again. So you bail him out by fouling him. And at this point in the game, he makes a great shot. But it's even more detrimental to the Knights' attack to have you on the bench.
Stadley now just 2 of 5 at the free throw line. One rival coach called him the best 1A player this year.
That's high praise.
9 points for him. Good hustle by Boyle. Lober has it. Kicked it back out to Boyle, and it's a whistle down low. We'll go against the Knights. It's happening. It's slowly starting to turn just a little bit in terms of the momentum for Cissna Park. And that's the reason why. Diving on the floor, creating opportunities for yourself as the Knights pick up another foul.
When I was looking at different universities, I didn't want to choose a campus just for football. I needed a school that offered strong academics. At UNI, I discovered a program that gave me hands-on experience and connected me with industry professionals. I gained a better understanding of what it takes to be successful in a competitive industry. UNI helped me discover my passion of meeting people and telling important community-driven stories. Discover where you belong at the University of Northern Iowa.
You can spend it on anything.
Animals and toys. I would buy a really, really, really big house.
A motorcycle.
I would go to college right now.
Money. Coats or watches. Anything.
Join NBC Sports Chicago for the last Blackhawks Authentic Fan Night of the season, Monday at the United Center. Watch the Hawks battle the Coyotes. Visit the Authentic Fan booth located outside Section 107. Grab a special St. Paddy's Day edition Blackhawks Authentic Fan t-shirt while supplies last. I like that. It's a good look. Can you grab one of those for me when you're up there?
I got you.
All right. So get to know Connor Lober of Cissna Park just a little better. The 5'10", 165-pound senior. Wishes he could backflip. Favorite TV show, Friends. Favorite pregame meal, mac and cheese.
That's interesting. Mac and cheese for the pregame meal?
Seems a little heavy.
It does. You don't want that coming out a different way, especially when you're playing. You know, for the pick up a charge, and you never know.
Friends.
Things shift around inside.
Friends is kind of an old school favorite TV show, right?
Yeah.
Ish.
Yeah. I never watched Friends.
I didn't either.
Yeah.
I was working it. I would like the backflip as well. I can appreciate that. Stadley up strong. They had a lot of good looks that they didn't finish in the super sectional, although they won that game by double digits. Yeah. Mason from the free throw line. Can't afford to not finish if you're Cissna Park at this point.
Fonte Thomas diving on the floor.
And the Knights will keep the ball thanks to his effort.
Well, Lee, you made a great point. At this point in the ball game, you have to finish those layups for the Saddlers. Great position. You got to complete the play.
Led by as many as 16. TJ Irvin hits the deck hard. Mason follows. It won't go. He's on the pogo stick again. Great effort, but no points for St. Mel that trip.
Big shot.
Sluice for three.
It just seems like Cissna Park just can't convert those stops into points. Something that's hurt them throughout these three quarters.
Whoa. Mason takes it up strong. Jackson loses it on the way to the hoop. Here comes Boyle. From the corner, Ian Rogers with the miss. You can hear the St. Mel coaches barking at their team.
I'm surprised Tim Urban hasn't checked himself into the game. He's just so energetic on the sidelines. He's making sure his players understand what they're in.
Christian Stadley works against the double team, fires it up, goes up strong, and the second effort gets the whistle. That's weight room, 250-pound bench press, 440-pound squat.
It's pure power. Great thing about that
from Christian Statley. You stop the clock. It's the 15 foul on St. Mel, and you have a chance to cut within the lead.
Got to start making free throws.
You do.
They've been shooting a lot more of them here in the postseason, 100 a day.
And it's interesting with Christian's release. It's a low release. It's not much arc on the shot. As we see the result on his shot comes up short. It's hitting the front lip of the rim. Just raise that arc up a little bit more. Might have some better success. But just check out the trajectory of the shot when he releases it. And his follow through. A little bit more. Had a little more lift on that one.
That was better. He's got 10 now. St. Mel's biggest lead, I believe, is 16. Here's Mason, strong against Julian Stadley.
Seen that a few times on the drives from Jason Mason. Christian Stadley pulling him away from that painted area where he's not comfortable. He goes right by him. Gets himself to the free throw line.
Two shots.
Mason, shoot.
Two shots.
Get a look at Mason, four-year varsity player. The thing he's able to do for St. Mel is create matchup issues. He can take the guards inside. He can take the big guys outside.
Extra kind of benefit to his game is once he gets into the lane, as he tried to attempt a couple of plays ago, he'll just go over the top of guys and try and dunk it.
Stadley picks it up. Julian grabbed it, and now a jump ball, and it will stay with the T-Wolves.
Well, I'll say this. He's not getting recognized in terms of what he's brought to the court as much on the broadcast, but Avante Thomas is providing some resistance in that lane. Now, he's only 6'3". Stadley's a 6'7", but he's providing some physicality in there.
Lober for three. Fair follows. Doesn't get it to go. That's a couple of good looks that Fair has had and unable to finish.
It's been that afternoon for the Timberwolves.
Keegan Boyle, Skeeter, as he's known to his coach, tried to pick up another charge there, but just wasn't set.
So you just try and beat TJ Irvin to the spot. It's a lot of speed from both players. It was all over the floor yesterday. That's in my final game. He's diving on the floor for loose balls, picking up charges, everything. There's Mason again.
And the whistle on Julian Stadley.
Foul on 35, Julian Stadley.
Kevin Long.
Two free throws.
His team
Mason.
Is not unused to facing. I don't think that's right. I don't think that sounds right. This isn't their first rodeo. Let's just put it that way. Yeah. They face tough teams all year, and he says, I'll put our strength of schedule up against anybody. They face GCMS, who played in the semifinals last night at 2A, Central Catholic from Bloomington. They played at the Pinckneyville tournament, faced 3A team from Salem. So it's something that he has worked on. And then an unscheduled game with all the snow outs and weather we had in January. It took them about 4 days to set up a game with Teutopolis, and they went down there and played in what was a great atmosphere, he said, and a postseason-type atmosphere, and great for his team.
Just love coaches that always challenge their teams with their schedules. You don't play those cupcake schedules. You don't get better that way. Yeah, it looks good on the resume in terms of what you rack up in wins, but still, you get to the state tournament, it's tough. You're going to face those teams that are maybe more athletic, have some shooters who just do different things, and you just get used to playing a certain style.
Well, I point that out, too, because people say, well, Cissna Park, yeah, sure. Who did they play? Well, they played a lot of good teams this year.
Yeah, they have. They are battle tested. They're here. They're in the state championship game, so it doesn't matter if you're 1A or 4A. You make it to the state championship, you're a tough team. You're a really good team.
Mentioned earlier, the five seniors from Cissna Park won state titles in seventh and eighth grade. Here's Julian Stadley taking it strong to the hoop and finishing.
And timeout. Interesting to talk to their junior high coach, though. The Stadleys had not seen a basketball game on TV when they were in fifth grade. They started playing. They didn't know anything about the game. They were guarding guys when they were on offense.
So they were guarding their own teammates.
And another – no, well, they were guarding the other team when they were playing offense.
Oh,
and
gotcha.
And then another game, they said, well, are you wearing the same jersey you wore the last game? And the Twins had switched jerseys. They didn't know they had to wear the same jersey every time. Not that anybody would have known,
yeah.
Because I don't think in fifth grade they were growing facial hair.
No, I don't think so either.
And you mentioned yesterday that Christian was kind enough to grow the facial hair so we could tell him apart.
The stash is there, man. Yeah. Just, you know, encourage him to keep going. He's trying to get the Lee Hall look. I understand it. We all can't reach that glory.
Oh,
but at the same time, we have to start somewhere.
Well, and Julian said, you know, the facial hair is just not my thing. So
it helps out. It just helps out everyone. It's like, yeah, you guys are identical twins. Thank you for so many. One of you guys is doing to do something different.
Right.
Thank
right.
you.
Right. TJ Irvin. Tim Irvin II, but he goes by TJ. You get to know him a little bit better. His favorite TV show, one of my favorites, that 70s show. Favorite pro team player, the retired Kobe Bryant. Other sport you'd play, football. He's kind of got that football mentality.
He does. Very tough. But if Kobe's your favorite player, why you got on Jordans? You got to throw on some Kobe's, man. Kobe played for the Lakers. I'm sure he has some yellow, some gold in that. Got the Jordans on, but I get it. TJ's like, I'm on the big stage. I got to wear my mics. Whoa.
Tough finish by Tyrell Nelson. Keegan Boyle trying to draw a charge and hit the deck hard. Nelson now with 9.
Well, it was a 12-point lead before that Nelson basket. And you start to feel things kind of go the way that the Timberwolves have so anxiously wanted. Good pump fake. Outstanding job from Christian Stadley. That was smart.
Jason Mason whistled for foul. You talked a lot this weekend about drip, okay? When you've got a school color of purple, why would you wear black uniforms? I don't understand. I know black uniforms are, you know, it's uniform drip, but come on.
Intimidation thing with the black uniform. I love the black uniforms. Especially in state playoffs, playoff time, black.
Remember, you could wear purple.
Save it for the home games, though. Maybe, I don't know, do an alternate jersey.
I wonder what my friend Rocky Hill, the former coach at Thornton, would say.
Rocky Hill, now he had drip. Rocky Hill had drip. Lee Hall,
That's why I'm wearing the purple coat today.
Exactly.
And Rocky Hill. We want to throw a shout out real quick to Washington basketball coach Kevin Brown, who brought teams to Carver Arena when he was with Central Catholic and with Washington. He's been going through some health struggles. Coach, if you're watching, we love you. You know, stay strong. Keep fighting that good fight. He on a leave of absence now. He coached for about half of the season, and we look forward to seeing you back on the floor next year.
Yes, we do.
Final minute here, third quarter. St. Mel comfortably in front, ranked number one in the state. Nice. A Chicago team, or will play for a state title here tonight in Class 2A.
What a show they put on against Top Corus.
Nelson, give to Mason. And we've got 8 minutes to play. And it's St. Mel comfortably ahead by 13, 8 minutes away from their first state title since the glory days of the mid-80s.
I was in a terrible accident when I was 14 years old. My recovery was a challenge, to say the least. What I have learned from this experience has inspired me to help others overcome their obstacles. My name is Stephen Carroll, and I'm a country financial representative. I do what I do now to help people achieve their goal, one step at a time.
Find a representative at TakeSimpleSteps.com.
Get your favorite Chicago teams at your fingertips with the My Teams app by NBC Sports. Stream the games, read articles, and more. Follow your pro teams like a pro and download the My Teams app today. Let's go into the St. Mel huddle with Coach Tim Urban.
8 minutes. Let's do offensive drill, defensive drill right here. Three baskets, three stops. Competitive. Three baskets, three stops. We're in five wide, we're in fish on defense. Let's get a basket. Let's be smart, okay? Let's be smart. Let's get a basket this possession.
That message from Coach Urban reminds me of my time as a Saluki under Chris Lowry. We had a drill where we would do score, shutout, score, and sometimes we would do shutout to finish things off. So it just teaches you when you have those moments, either you're up like St. Mel is, or you need to come back within a ball game, that you have to transition your mind from, okay, we need a basket, we got the basket. Let's get the stop, let's continue the build to either add to the lead or cut within the lead.
Intent to work a little clock here and be patient. And Christian Stanley picks up the foul.
Christian Stanley, team foul four, out of bounds for Providence-St. Mel.
It's just the fourth team foul, so they've got a few to give to get to the bonus and try and set up free throws and stop the clock. And a charging call. Going to go against Eric Jordan, as it was Brian Fair taking the charge this time. Usually it's Keegan Boyle.
Yeah, that was a lot of courage. I'll put it that way from Fair. Look at him stand in and take it. And if you're Eric Jordan, no need for that. Bring that ball back out. If you're St. Mel, unless it's a clear lane for a wide open layup, just bring it back out and work the clock and force Cissna Park to defend you. You don't do that, now you're back on defense. The Cissna Park is still 13. They get a basket here again. It's still a ball game.
Sluice for three. Gets a good look at it that time, but bounces it no good. Deion Jackson to finish the other way.
So quick from defense to offense. Deion Jackson, he just finds a launching pad when he gets inside the lane and scores it. Unbelievable quickness from the Knights.
Whistle against Nelson. It's his third.
Head up from Nelson over to Jackson again. There's that launching pad. Off 2 feet and just flies past Ian Rogers for two.
One and one, fellas.
Love his old school game. Doesn't stretch out to the three. He's only had one made three on the season. He just lives 15 feet and in.
Boyle, 58% free thrower on the season. Junior will start baseball season on Monday.
Kevin Long's going to extend his defense. Trying to go a 1-2-2. We can go man-to-man. I'm not sure. They're a little confused on what's happening.
Just a trap. St. Mel beats it. Ahead here by 13. Hard to believe this St. Mel team started season 2-3.
Yeah. Had some tough losses to DePaul Prep, along with Christian Academy out of St. Louis and St. Lawrence.
DePaul Prep will be here next week. We already know that by virtue of the trouble of the game last night.
Chicago.
And it's very unfortunate with Lawndale McCurdy.
Altercation in the game that involved fans, and both teams were given a double forfeit. So DePaul Prep will be here next weekend. Peoria Manuel is in the super sectional with a chance to have a home team here in the Peoria area next weekend. Tyrell Nelson with 11. Inside to Staddley. And it's TJ Irvin whistled for the foul. He got a lot of ball. I thought maybe he was going to get a jump ball call there.
Ball on Tim Irvin, the second. King Paul, 9. At the line, Julian Staddley.
Julian Staddley at the free throw line, 9th in career points, 6th in career rebounding. Christian's kind of known as more as the offensive of the two twins, but Julian has really improved his game, improved in the weight room, number one, and improved Max's in the weight room.
I mentioned Christian shooting 77% from the field on the season. Julian is right behind him, 69%. 11.6 boards. There's both the Staddley twins are struggling from the free throw line. It's full scramble mode for Cissna Park. And that's a tough thing to be in with a great ball handling team like Providence-St. Mel. Prime example.
Gift from Nelson to Jackson. Jackson with 11. Second team All-Stater, Knack around the basket. Sluice, the long three is short. And that's the one thing we really haven't maybe talked about a lot, is just the defensive pressure and how it's forcing Cista away from the basket.
Yeah, first quarter, especially early on, you saw Cista Park getting a lot of post touches, attacks to the rim. And as the game went on, they slowly started to move away from that lane area. And now they're taking tough NBA range threes.
So we touched on it a little bit earlier. The idea that Chicago has a chance to sweep the state final this year. St. Mel leading this game in 1A. In 2A, Chicago Orr will play tonight for the championship against Nashville. Bogan's still alive in 3A after knocking off Morgan Park last night, I believe.
It's a huge win. Yes, they finally got over the Morgan Park hurdle.
And 4A, Curie is taking on Simeon for a trip to state in the super section.
I believe there is one team in Southern Illinois that has something to say about that 4A state championship. Belleville West. And that monster, not a monster, a monster in E.J. Liddell. that young man is a true talent. Belleville West won the state championship last year and went into overtime with Whitney Young. They still exist.
Yep. Joe Muniz's team winning last night. Take the sectional final. Chance to come back here and maybe make it back-to-back state championship. So we'll see. And
yeah.
It was just a couple of years ago that Chicago took three of the four Orr in 2A, Morgan Park in 3A, and Young won the 4A title. So we'll see. It's just something interesting to kind of kick around here.
Very possible.
TJ Irvin now with 6 points.
Mention his pressure on the ball. Stumbles a little bit. He's hurting right now.
Yeah, you can see him. He has to come out.
Saw he took a spill on that ball screen from the Staddley twins.
Well, we'll check on TJ Irvin and go to a break. It's St. Mel looking strong as they head for a state championship.
All across America, teenagers are making a difference, gaining respect, and changing the future. Here in Illinois, the future is now. 16 and 17-year-olds can now register to be organ tissue donors in Illinois. Nearly 5,000 people in our state need a life-saving organ, and about 300 people die every year waiting. Be part of the solution. Join the Illinois Secretary of State's Organ Tissue Donor Registry. Register at lifegoeson.com.
This event is brought to you by Champion. Since 1919, Champion has created the durable, authentic sportswear you need to conquer your goals. As the official uniform and apparel provider for the NFHS, Champion helps athletes at every level make their mark, the mark of a champion. View our apparel today at champion.com.
And we are back in Peoria, the 1A state championship game. NBC Sports Chicago is the home for IHSA basketball championships. Coverage continues Friday. The boys class 3A semifinals at 11 a.m. You can also live stream the games at NBCSportsChicago.com/IHSA. Deion Jackson transferred from Uplift before his junior year, and he has given a lift to this St. Mel program. 11 points to tie for team high honors.
His game resides right from free throw line extended to lower. And this is all of his buckets are coming. See the nice back door there, get that reverse to go. So athletic in the open court, and there's the explosion from Jackson. Young man that was second team All-State for Class 1A, and just so confident about his game. Very poised when that basketball is in his hands.
Jim Irvin saying he is ultra athletic and has an old school mid-range game. 1 of 5 from three-point range on the year. Brian Fair picks up the offensive rebound and scores.
Everyone's gonna call a quick timeout. Set up their defense. Force a turnover with a quick trap.
Somebody's already crashed out there. Look at
man.
That.
Are you not entertained?
Here's our gift of hope, assist of the game, going from Brian Fair to his All-State teammate, Christian Stadley.
Stadley flexing a little bit off this pass from Fair. Lefty finish. I'll tell you this, Timberwolves got more of that. More finishes at the rim. This will be a different ball game. I'm jealous of the young lady with that nap. That's how I'm going to be later on tonight.
Yeah.
You know you're sleeping good when you have a little drool coming out, a little slop. I'm just everybody. If you know that, then okay. I'm not telling you anything new. But if you don't, that's a sign of a good sleep.
I posted a meme the other day that said, "Dear Naps, I'm sorry I was so mean to you in kindergarten." They are underrated. I think we should institute that.
I need to show that to my 2-year-old son. Because he does not.
That's right.
He has to be forced to go to sleep.
Yeah. The things that used to be punishments are my life now. Naps, staying home at night, going to sleep early.
Yep.
You talk about these two teams and their journeys to state started long ago. I mean, for Cissna Park, they were under 500 when these seniors were sophomores and made it to the sectional final. They lost to Ridgeview last year. They thought, well, we're going to go make another deep run. They lost in the regional final, so that was a bit of a wake-up call for Kevin Long's program. On the other side, St. Mel, we talked about it. They lost in the super sectional last year to Sterling Newman Catholic, and Tim Irvin's team just really, I mean, that's still a sore spot for them.
It haunts them. I think you bring up the name Sterling Newman Catholic, and they just shake a little bit just because they know that they were right there, seconds away, maybe a minute or two, but seconds away from reaching the Final Four in Class 1A.
And you talk about the other state champion, and we're assuming that that's the way this is going to end. For St. Mel, you go back to 1985, Lowell Hamilton's team that won a state championship the year before they finished third.
Yeah.
So it's those are the kind of things, a couple of things I love about IHSA basketball is the motivation from one year to the next like that. And then the other, just the threads of different things of how things tie together and the coaches tie together and different stories about how
Well, I coached for this team. Like, you know, I coached in this town, and then I ended up coaching against those kids later in my life. It's just there's just that interconnection between teams and coaches. It's just great fun.
It's awesome. I still have conversations with guys that I played against in the Chicago Catholic League. One player in particular, Gerard Haynes, a celebrated actor now, is going to be on NBC's The Village that's coming up in a couple of weeks, their premiere episode for season one. He attended Hell's Franciscan, and we see each other all the time, and we just talk about the battles that we had and just now how we're closer with friends now than we were when we were playing against each other, because when you're playing against each other, you're not buddy-buddy with guys. There's a heavy dislike for that player. But it's just awesome to see these young men redeem themselves from last season.
For Cissna Park, playing in their first state championship game ever. Just their second trip to state under Kevin Long. Foul there on Bailey Sluice. Talk about redeeming yourself. He was a transfer from Watseka, and Kevin Long said, you know, his basketball IQ wasn't where it is now, and wasn't sure at times that he'd make it, but saw potential in him, and he's just been an invaluable player on this team with, 92 three-point makes on the year.
We haven't seen it in this championship game, but you mentioned it, Lee, with that stat. He's a knockdown shooter, but Coach Long has been even more impressed with this commitment to the defensive end and becoming more of a complete player instead of just a one-dimensional guy.
Brian Fair called for traveling. He thought it was a jump ball.
Impressive job from Jason Mason, just walling up, arms straight in the air. Look at him, wall up. Dip the hand down a little bit on top of the ball. And that's what you teach, arms straight up. Good defense from the Knights.
TJ Irvin comes back after limping off. He's kind of shaking that foot a little bit, making sure he's got some feeling there.
Sat down with TJ Irvin earlier this year in the game that was featured in the Knights against St. Rita in the Chicago Catholic League. And just a young man that has an outstanding GPA. I believe it's upward towards a 4.0. But he understands the history. And, you know, his dad is the head coach. His dad went to Providence-St. Mel. But he's huge on history and what this means for not only the school, but also for the west side of Chicago. He wants to bring that state championship trophy back to Central Park Avenue.
I think I saw that interview, and he's a well-spoken young man, and his dad, I mean, we had a great conversation with him about his days walking on at Purdue and playing for Gene Cady and playing with the big dog Glenn Robinson and Kunzo Martin, and how they still talk often, and the influence that Coach Cady was on him as a coach now, and says a lot of the stuff I run at practice now comes from Coach Cady.
Why not?
Yeah, right?
Coach Cady was an all right coach, I guess, you know. You know, we can pick some things from his coaching philosophies to help you win games.
Yeah, we had a chance to interview him one time down in West Lafayette. I remember as Bailey Sluice gets a nice hand as he comes off for the final time in his career.
And interesting enough, with that coaching tree from Coach Cady, my freshman year at Southern Illinois, put a good shot of Kevin Long just embracing Brian Fair, excuse me.
6'2 senior, four-year varsity player for Coach Long. Big round of applause. And Coach Cady, and just to finish that point, Tim Irvin said, you know, as fiery as he was on the floor, he was that much of a nice guy off.
Injury timeout.
And something happened off camera there. Keegan Boyle down on the floor.
Well, I saw him make contact with Tayon Neal, but I'm not sure on what area of the body where he's hurting.
He gives up the body and just
does
incredible selflessness on defense. Oh, that's.
What happened?
Kevin Long says this team has been tough together in adversity all year. Year in and year out, you know, 24 years in a community. He talked about his kids and how they're ultimate team players, and that comes from their upbringing. So there is it's a love affair between Kevin Long and his program and the kids and the community too.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because that's where it starts. It starts at home. And a big hand for Keegan Boyle.
See Coach Long giving Boyle a big hug. And Kevin Boyle is going to be one of those guys, along with Tim Urban, that when these young men start to, you know, get married and have families, he's going to be there. He's going to be at their weddings. He's going to be at those baby showers. Maybe even babysitting a couple times.
Yeah, maybe. And now the applause will rain down on the floor here as the Stadley twins come out. Christian first.
And I'll say this for Cissna Park. They have no reason to hang their heads. None at all. I know the pain of coming up short of your goal, it's there. I know it's heavy. But at the same time, you made history for your school and for your program by reaching the state championship.
It will be the first basketball trophy in school history. We play out the 1A state championship game here. St. Mel has been in control the entire way. And here's a big hand for Julian Stadley. We mentioned the emotion coming from Julian Stadley. When a coach says something about proud beyond words as a parent, I'm sure you can relate to this. Some things you just can't put into words.
Yes.
And that bond, and you know, when you spend day after day in the gym in the summer and all through the dead of winter, I mean, you become a family. There's no doubt about it.
Just let your emotions, as we've seen from Coach Long, let your words be emotions. Your emotions are your words.
And I love how Coach Long's handled it. He says, I've told the seniors all year long, and the seniors have backed him up. They said, you know, he's told us it's not about him, it's about us. You know, and he got that 500th win in his career and said, it just means I'm an old guy and I coached a lot of good players. And now at the other end, as Connor Lober, the senior, comes off. Now a big hand for this big fella, Tayon Neal, the honorable mention All-State senior. So it's whether you're in a small town in central Illinois or the big city of Chicago, it's teammates, it's brothers, it's family.
Yes.
And you go back and read, Lowell Hamilton went back for a reunion a couple of years ago, and you read what he had to say about St. Mel. He's like, those guys I played with were my brothers. You know, playing on the west side and growing up in the conditions we grew up in. Yeah. You know, we were brothers, there's no doubt.
And that's why it means so much for these young men. You see the emotion from Tayon Neal as Tyrell Nelson is walking off, and he will celebrate with his coaches and be embraced. But I understand the circumstances and the challenges they come from, because I'm from the west side of Chicago as well, and it's difficult. It really is. But you have a piece of light within you, and growing up with the state championship, you can bring that and say, this is my contribution to not only the school but also the community, and it helps inspire the next generation.
Oh yeah.
And that's why this is so huge on so many levels for this Providence-St. Mel team.
And let me, if I can, kind of continue that point with you. How important the programs, whether you're a state champion or not, mm-hmm. are in the young lives of these young men. Because you only have one state champion in each class, as Deion Jackson comes off and gets big hugs on the Providence-St. Mel bets. That's true of a lot of places.
Yes,
right.
Yes, 100% sure. It doesn't matter if you're from the west side, south side, sits in the park. It means everything for these kids.
Yeah,
extra effort on the glass for Corey Brooks of St. Mel. Oh, not quite there for Rudy King, the 6 foot junior.
Now this is the embrace I'm waiting for. TJ Irvin, his final game as a member of the Providence-St. Mel basketball team, playing for his dad.
Yep. He's been his coach since he was in kindergarten. Dad'll be the last one. He's still coaching.
That's just Tim Irvin.
I'm going to see him tonight. I'll see him tomorrow night and the next night. The entire bench rooting for Titus Irvin, the freshman brother of TJ, out there getting one in the air. Well, and I love what Coach Irvin had to say about that. He said, been coaching him since he was in kindergarten. I've heard horror stories. We set boundaries early on. No talking about basketball once we get to the car. The gym, yes. Not in the car, not at home.
And he says even after losses that TJ doesn't ride with dad. He rides with mom after the games. Wins, they ride
just
together.
Just in case.
Yeah.
Final minute here. 1A state championship game. The drama has gone out of this, but you have to appreciate the effort and the execution of this Providence-St. Mel team, ranked number one to get here and finish the season number one. Jump hook that time from Rudy King.
Ooh, bringing out the tools. Okay, Rudy.
Titus, yes. He gets in the scorebook as a freshman. They don't raise regional and sectional banners in the Providence-St. Mel gym. They save them for state champions, 1985 and now 2019. These young men join the immortal Lowell Hamilton and his teammates. Winners in 1985. It's been a long time since that one. Forever. The top-ranked St. Mel Knights, the state champs in 1A.
Forever cements it in history, not only at Providence-St. Mel High School, but the state of Illinois.
Here's our Wintrust play of the game. You know, they talk about Peoria being the home of the ankle breakers. That was back in the day when the Peoria Emanuel guys were winning state championships. They'd have been proud of that one from Tyriel Nelson. Our Wintrust play of the game. Our Country Financial player of the game, Tyriel Nelson. Tyriel, 15 points, 4 rebounds, 5 assists for the state champions from St. Mel.
First team All-Stater, as you said, Lee, state champion.
So the 1A state championship is headed to the Windy City. TJ Irvin. Tears of joy for that young man.
Just days and hours of sacrifice, time in the gym, balancing your academics for your sport so you can experience this moment.
Let's go to Piper Shaw.
Hey guys, I've got Tyriel Nelson here with me. Congratulations. Coach said you guys made a commitment to make history. You've done that today. How do you feel?
It's a great feeling. It's what we've been working for since seventh grade. And we've been building up to this. Each year, we got a step closer. We finally did it.
Who's this win for?
This win is for us. This is for us, all the people that ever doubted us. Like, the love for our fans, our founder, principal, coach, each other. It's for love.
Now, you guys proved why you were the number one team. What would you say to the naysayers?
To the who?
The naysayers.
We did it. That's all I can say is we did it. That's the whole trip. It's the, we had a revenge tour. It's now completed. Proved them wrong. Proved everybody that doubted us wrong.
Thank you so much. Congratulations again. I'm going to bring in your coach over here. Hey, coach, going to grab you really quick. Congratulations, first and foremost. How do you feel?
I feel great. I feel great. It's unimaginable how I feel. Been dreaming about this, been working towards this. This is a great feeling. The state of Illinois does a great job with their basketball sports, and I love it. And this feels great to be able to say that I'm a state champion. I am excited, overexcited.
Now, when you sit back and you remember this moment with both of your sons winning a state title, what are you going to talk about? How does it feel?
Oh, it's going to feel great. I can't wait to have that conversation, especially if I have some grandsons around to be able to talk about just how great this feeling is. It's a wonderful feeling to be able to win a state championship with my two sons. One's a freshman, one's a senior. I couldn't ask for anything better. God has blessed me. God is awesome. He has blessed me to see this, and I am so grateful to God who has allowed this to happen for us.
What do you think when you look at your players who are so emotional right now?
I look at them and say, the journey has been completed, but we can rest now. We can be excited about it. We go down in history. We made history today by becoming the state champions in 2019 in Class 1A. So now their names will live in history forever.
When you saw Titus's shot at the end there, what did you think? I saw that reaction.
I was like, oh, is it going to go in? Yeah! Oh, I'm very excited for him. Very excited. I knew he was going to do it because he told me, Dad, if I get in the game, I'm shooting the basketball.
And he sure did. Thank you so much. Congratulations.
Thank you. To God be the glory. Thank you.
All right, Lee, over to you.
All right. Well, now I know where TJ gets his enthusiasm, right? Tim Urban with the state championship. And you talk about redemption, and well, what a story. Three seasons, he was fired after his third year after going 0-25, and now to get back third in 2014. There's Dad's reaction. Oh, yeah. It was almost like they got as much joy out of that as they got out of winning the state championship. 0-25 in 03, third place in 14, and now state champions. Their motto was, we ain't done yet. Mm-hmm. Well, they are done, and they are number one.
Coach Urban said, we can rest now. We've achieved our goal. We've got that complete. Your names will live in history forever. No one will be able to take away the state championship from Providence-St. Mel in Class 1A.
Athletic Director, Rich Thompson.
52-29, the final score for the state champions from Providence-St. Mel. It's awards time now. We begin with fourth place, Cissna Park.
Head coach.
Check that, fourth place, Triopia.
Assistant coach, Neil Meyer. Manager, Isaac Workman. Manager, Russell Gregory.
Congratulations.
Now the Trojan players. Number one, Daniel Embley. Two, Sean Bell. Three, Zach Thompson. Five, Justin Bacher.
Still pretty strong, man.
10, Caden Moore. 11, Garrett Snow.
Congratulations.
12, Brady Beard.
Congratulations.
13, Chase Stock.
Congratulations.
21, Michael Burns.
Congrats.
22, Jacob Laycamp.
Congratulations.
23, Garrett Bell.
Congratulations.
33, Connor Bridgewater.
34, Brock Moore. 35, Tanner Allen. 44, Zach Rowland.
34,
statistician, Jared Milby.
34,
scorekeeper, Dean Wearies. Triopia Co-op Trojans, fourth place, 1A 2019. Congratulations. Well, Coach Lewis and the captains of Triopia step forward to receive the fourth place trophy. In third place, 2019 1A, the Central A&M Raiders, 33-4. Superintendent, Dr. Deanne Heck. Principal, Charlie Brown. Athletic Director, Sean Hayes. Certified Athletic Trainer, Mike Goodendorf. Head Coach, Rob Smith. Assistant Coach, Brent Wheatley. Assistant Coach, Michael Greer.
Thank you.
Assistant Coach, Drew Himes. And now the Raiders players. 10, Ross Sloan. 12, Isaac Knightfer. 14, Griffin Andricks. 20, Jacob Paradis. 22, Connor Heaton. 23, Bryson Bergner. 24, James Paradis. 30, Austin Sloan. 32, Connor Hutchins. 33, Chris Enge. 34, Caleb Woods. 42, Cord Fenton. 44, Keegan Bagley. 45, Tori Palmer. 55, Keegan Waterman. The Central A&M Raiders, third place, 33-4. This time would Coach Smith and the captains of Central A&M step forward to receive the third place trophy. And now the second place, Cissna Park Timberwolves, a record of 33-5. Their superintendent, Dr. Daniel Heilberg. Principal, Mark Portwood. Athletic Director, Josh Landon. certified athletic trainer Jesse Schwartz. Head coach Kevin Long. Assistant coach Seth Johnson. Assistant coach Vincent Lober. Manager Theron Blank. Manager Dawson Savory. Manager Tanner Garrison. Scorekeeper Gail Lober. And now the Timberwolf players. Five, Connor Lober. 10, Devin Hull. 11, Keegan Boyle. 14, Bailey Sluice. 20, Penn Stoller. 22, Brian Fair. 24, Ian Rogers. 25, Malachi Verkler. 35, Julian Stadley. 40, Christian Stadley. 42, Zane Pierce. 44, Rudy King. And 55, Ryan King. The Timberwolves of Cissna Park. Second place, 33-5. This time will Coach Long and the captains of Cissna Park step forward to receive the runner-up trophy. The 1A 2019 champions, the Providence-St. Mel Knights, 30-6. Their founder, Paul J. Adams III. Principal, Jeanette Butala.
Congratulations.
Athletic Director, Teresa Cullen. Head coach, Tim Irvin. Assistant coach, Eric Marshall. Assistant coach, Reginald Murray. Assistant coach, Andre Williams. Assistant coach, Corey Allen. Manager, Todd Kennebrew. Manager, Sam Smith. Manager, Samuel Sutton. And now the Knights players. Two, Tim Irvin the second. Three, Eric Jordan the second. Four, Titus Irvin. Five, Jordan Green. 10, Jason Mason. 13, Deion Jackson. 15, Tyrell Nelson. 20, Corey Brooks. 22, Jonathan Gregory. 24, Samuel Harrington. Kyair Butts. 30, Makai Alexander. 32, Avante Thomas. And 33, Tayon Neal. The Providence-St. Mel Knights first place, 1A 2019. At this time with head coach Tim Irvin and the captains of Providence-St. Mel step forward to receive the championship trophy, 1A 2019. Congratulations. Thank all of you for being here, the site of America's original March Madness. We hope you enjoy your stay.
Hold the state championship trophy. There's not much argument, right?
Not at all. Not at all. It has to feel like such a relief just to hoist that up and really show it to your family and friends. Outstanding job from the Knights.
Your thoughts overall after this weekend?
I'm excited. I wish I could have played. It was that good. I mean, the competition level was outstanding from all Final Four teams that we've had, and I'm really inspired for what we'll see going forward in Class 2A tonight and 3A and 4A next weekend.
It was a great weekend of basketball here, as you see the results today. And coming up tonight, it's Corliss and GCMS in the 2A consolation game, followed by Nashville and Chicago or the Windy City going for two straight, 1A and 2A. And on the other side, Nashville, Wayne Hari trying to become the first coach in IHSA history to win a state championship on the girls' side and the boys' side. So that's an interesting sidebar story there. Number one, Nashville, against number two, Orr. Providence-St. Mel, third in 2014. They come back this year and take home the big trophy. TJ Irvin celebrating with his teammates and his father, the head coach. Number one in the final poll and number one in Class 1A. Congratulations to all our trophy winners this weekend. For Cameron Smith, Piper Shaw, and our crew, I'm Lee Hall. So long from Peoria.